In surveys that have been carried out throughout London, one of the biggest complaints received by councils has been about the lack of parking space. So as part of a continuing campaign, Westminster today started work to create an extra 2,000 parking spaces in the city. Research has shown that there are simply too many yellow lines on roads restricting parking, and that many more of them can be literally burnt off. By doing this, they intend to increase the number of resident bays in Westminster from 27,000 to 29,000, and the number of parking meters from 1,016 to just over 1,200. There'll also be a scheme that will enable tradesmen, household repair and service engineers and delivery people to use some of the bays for a limited time each day, which, say the council, should improve the lot of those who live in Westminster.
Yellow lines have been were introduced many years ago, and the criteria for introducing them are very different to the criteria we're looking at nowadays. We're saying, let's have residence parking spaces wherever we can, and only yellow lines where necessary because of road safety problems, etc. It's important that we produce more parking for residents who live in Westminster. And obviously, there are more cars now in Westminster owned by genuine residents. And today we're looking to try and improve the services we provide by ensuring that they can park as close as possible to where they live.
The council say the work will be finished by the end of March, but they go on to say that if anyone in the borough thinks there are too many yellow lines in their streets which stop parking and which should therefore go, then they should contact the council, which will see what more can be done. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.
Michael George, on the face of it, good news, but isn't it a charter for illegal parkers simply to clog up our streets?
Well, it's certainly good news, and it's something we've been calling for a long time. At last, it's happened, and we're delighted. If the scheme is put in properly, and the provisions that the Westminster Council have put in to trap illegal motorists, it should work out well. As long as that's done efficiently, there should be no problem.
So who does it help and who does it hinder?
Well, it's certainly going to help the residents. They know that they're going to get a parking space. There's a lack of parking for residents. Now they know they're going to get that. During the day, there's going to be space available for business users and others who might want to pay for it. That's good. But the people who aren't being helped are the business users during the day. We want to give them parking during the day so that they can go about their daily activities. That's what we need more of.
But many people would argue that this is simply a cosmetic, almost a political exercise.
Well, it may be that, but we certainly hope it isn't. It's going to be the start of something a lot bigger.
It's not a curtain raiser for more and more motorists to be charged to come into certain parts of London with special stickers on their windscreens.
Yes, well, you've got to expect to park in the centre of London. I mean, there's high-rise car parks and the lot. You've got to pay for those, so you've got to expect to pay to come and park in the centre of London.
And is it something that you expect other boroughs to follow suit?
Well, we certainly hope it blazes a trail for other boroughs to follow the example that Westminster Council have set and provide more off-street parking for business and residence users.
Thank you very much. And we'll take a short break there. In part two, the mums who want a special deal for their sick children. We look at the big Meccano sell-off. And the hammers stay top, but pay the price. Join us again.